Stan Buddle, I hope, and Peter Buckley of Birmingham. Peter Buckley, first man into the ring, the Midlands area champion. And there's a record supplied by George Zellery, our statistician, the editor of Boxing Outlook magazine. The latest issue on sale now. 21 years of age is Peter, and in fight number 31 tonight. And as you can see, won 16 of them, but just two by the short route. Now there'll be a welcome for the next boy into the ring, Mark Bates, from Stanford Low. That's just right down the road from here where we are in Basildon. Now you see what I'm telling you, the local fan club here in force tonight. Mark Bates' record. Ranked number 16 in the UK. Pro box corners, and in comes Mark Bates. Our MC tonight is Alan Hughes.
We now welcome all our viewers on Screen Sport in the United Kingdom, Sportnet in Holland and Belgium, TV Sport in France, and Sport Canal in Germany to Basildon's Festival Hall for an evening of championship boxing promoted by Matchroom and sponsored by the Daily Mirror. All your officials for this evening are appointed by the British Boxing Board of Control. This contest is a super featherweight contest at 9 stone 4 pounds over 6 3-minute rounds. Introducing in the red corner with the white shorts from Birmingham, Peter Buckley. And his opponent in the blue corner with the black shorts from Stamford Lee Hope, Mark Bates. At the weigh-in today, Buckley scaled 9 stone 4 pounds, Bates 9 stone 2 pounds. Your referee for this contest is Tony Walker and your timekeeper, Danny Peacock.
Tony Walker, the third man in the middle. We've got 6 3-minute rounds. Well, Jimmy, Mark Bates is a boy we've seen often enough, and like so many of the young boxers in the Matchroom stable, this is a real make or break season for them. They've got to advance up the ladder.
Yeah,
check it out.
What we've seen Mark Bates so far is a very exciting young prospect, and I'm sure that Mark Bates will be looking to do just that in his coming season.
Mark Bates, as we say, 24 years of age, ranked 16, and really in the coming months, if he's to have ambitions in this game, he's got to get himself into the top 10. Peter Buckley got a 2-pound weight advantage coming in at 9-4, opposed to Mark Bates 9-2. Although, having said that, Jimmy, Mark Bates looks physically the bigger of the two boys.
Yeah, Mark looks in great shape as well. He's got nice definition about him, and he looks the more solid guard, I'd say. Now, Buckley, let's not forget, he's had 30 professional contests, so he's an experienced campaigner. He's been around and has come into Mark Bates' backyard here at Basildon tonight, and he'll be looking to cause all sorts of problems.
Yes, Mark was to have met that canny little performer, Lee Fox, of Chesterfield tonight, but Lee indisposed. Oh, good right hand from the Midland boy, Peter Buckley.
Mark starting off nice and steadily. I'm sure we'll gradually see him increase his punch rate and work rate as the minutes tick away.
Come on, lad.
interesting note looking at Mark is, although he's got a lot of big following here tonight, he's gone out there, he's nice and composed, nice and relaxed, all within himself, and he's picking his shots nicely. He's landed one or two cracking right hands over the top. Looks like he's trying to set that shot up.
He picked up quite a nasty hand injury last year, did Mark Bates. He was out of the game for a good 6 months or so. And we saw his comeback fight. That was also against Lee Fox, who, as I said earlier, he was supposed to meet tonight. But that was a good performance after a 6 month out of the game.
Yeah, it certainly was, because Lee Fox is a very tough little pro, very aggressive and pretty cagey and canny and throws all sorts of good shots, and Mark done a very impressive professional like job on him.
End of the first of the scheduled 6 3-minute rounds. I reckon Bates shaded up.
Yeah, no question. Mark got through with some nice right hands, two particularly big shots in that round. He just basically picked his shots very casually and calmly. And I'm sure we'll see him slip through the gears and increase the pace as the crowd get behind him and starts to unload. It gets the crowd buzzing with a little bit of excitement. I'm sure that's what he'll be looking to do.
Yes, don't look for any big hitting in this bout. Both boys have had inside the distance wins. Mark Bates, 3 of his 8 wins inside the distance, and Peter Buckley just 2 out of 16. I think you're going to find a tactical battle tonight, and there's no doubt this boy here, Peter Buckley, having his 31st professional contest tonight, maybe has one or two little tricks up his sleeve. Midland area champion, as I say, but he's the sort of fighter that Bates is going to have to overcome if he's to advance his career range. Round two then. Mark Bates in the black and Peter Buckley in the white.
Hey, now Buckley's got to start imposing himself a little bit on Bates if he's thinking about winning this contest, because once Mark settles into his rhythm and start getting accurate with the shots and the crowd getting behind him, he'll have a real uphill task then. Clean, even fight, nice one for the referee to work on. He hasn't had to step in at all. All the shots are clean and nicely delivered. And you can see both boys are trying to think and outthink one another. That's an interesting blend of styles. Quick switch to the southpaw stance there for Buckley. A few of the tricks you were talking about, though.
Yeah, exactly. An attempt to just make the younger boy think a little bit. Switch back to orthodox now as Buckley. Yeah, left hand, left foot forward.
He's a canny guy. Nice and smart. Like, he's occasionally backing off, he'll leap him with like a big right hand, like just there, or come over the left hook. So, and Mark Bates can't just walk in, he's got to think about what he's doing, set the guy up, do plenty of feinting, plenty of kidding. Ball landing it, the shots of the guy.
But Bates is just boxing nicely, ain't going crazy, but he's still nicking away and taking this round as well.
There you go, peck with the jab, then comes that big right hand over the top and the jaw down.
If you look at Buckley, he's a much more mobile fighter. He's trying to present more elusive target. Both is a little bit upright, in and out.
Yeah, it's the blender style is interesting to watch. Mark Bates is very, as you said, very upright, very British style. Pecks away with a jab, looks at a big traditional right hand over the top. Buckley, for his part, looks the more fluid of the two fighters without the sort of ambition. I think that's the deciding factor, I think, about the ambition that Mark Bates carries. You can see here that the piece of action here, Buckley's pecking away with a jab, Mark's on his back foot, and takes a right hand, which just makes him think that, you know, Buckley's going to be dangerous and I'm going to have to keep my awareness about him at all times. Guy's a KGL pro.
Yeah, well, there's a little bit of height and reach advantage. Bates can out-jab Buckley, but Connell just jig and work and jinx his way inside, which is good boxing. Nice little fight, as I show.
Round three,
then, reaching the halfway stage of this super featherweight contest. Mark Bates from Stanford La Hope in Essex, flat trunks. Peter Buckley from Birmingham, the Midlands area champion in white.
We wonder whether Buckley might try something now in terms of changing the pattern of the fight and try and just test out exactly what Bates has got when he's put under the cross a little bit.
Yeah, I'd like to see him step the pace up a little bit.
No, because he boxes in this gear and just stays at his pace in this type of catch-as-can situation, he's going to find himself getting outpointed.
Yes. I would not disagree. And you can see that Buckley's quite clearly a counter-puncher. But he's got to overcome maybe his natural instincts and try and force the pace of this contest a little bit.
Yeah, you know, it's okay being cagey, but you know, you've got to find out what you want to be. And, you know, Mark Bates is determined to go on to bigger and better things. And Mark's fighting with the ambition to do just that, making him a little bit more determined to be the first man to the punch and to make sure that he dominates.
A good attack from Buckley. That's the best little sustained spell he's had.
This fight is most aggressive, solid movement, putting both punches together to an end body. That's the type of action that it's going to take the hope to win this contest.
And Bates was completely taken by surprise. I think he might have just switched off mentally a little bit. He was rocked on his heels by that little assault.
I think it was a body shot that actually hurt him. He got caught with a crunching left hook to the side of the ribcage. Them type of shots are the ones that make you go cold.
Well, this is what I mean, Jimmy, about changing the pace of a fight. Well, when a fighter gets into a little groove where he's just jabbing and moving, if his opponent suddenly does something different, it's very hard to instantly react.
Absolutely. I mean, I learnt very early in my boxing career through sparring with good class opponents that once you can style and work out a guy's pattern, most fighters stick to a similar pattern all the way through. And watching this is like watching it happen right in front of me, and they've both basically sussed out one another's pattern. It's up to one or the other to do something different and change the course of the fight. And from Buckley's point of view, it's to become aggressive and punch with both hands, as he'd done just for a few split seconds at the start of this round. And it looked a different fight at that stage, even though it was only briefly.
Not a bad round for Buckley.
Have you got round for Buckley?
Yes, I would indeed.
He needs some more of that, though. He needs to come out at the start of this round and really come forward with an aggressive onslaught and try and break the pattern apart. Bates, he's boxing very smoothly and calmly. It hasn't been pushed out of first gear just yet.
Halfway stage, and, well, on my card, you can't separate it.
Let's just have a look at the action here of this aggressive attack by Buckley. He's chasing after the retreating Bates, throwing the right hand over the top. And there's that crunching up I was talking about downstairs, and also one or two got through to the side of the head. I think it was the body shot, Dave, that actually, for a split second, was the one that Mark Bates will be thinking about right now. It was the crunching left hook underneath.
Corey Dendegan. Check it out. Round four.
Tony Walker, who's had very little to do in this contest. Separates both.
That was a good left foot there from Buckley. Bang on the target. I see Mark Bates start trying to get back into some driving seat and start banging that right hand over, because he's having a lot of success with that early in the fight. He's tended to become a little bit one-paced and one-handed. He's pecking away with the left hand, but he's got two hands to see him use them.
Period of about 10 seconds then, when not a blow was thrown and nobody moved, looking for the key. Buckley certainly looks the more dangerous of these two when he gets in close.
I think the difference is at this stage of the fight is that Buckley's actually got a taste of the fight now.
Well, having said that, was a good crisp left hand from Mark Bates, and that really jolted the Birmingham boys' head back.
I think that's when Peter Buckley has his success, when he bangs them body shots in. He really seems to put the pain, the expression shows on Bates' face when he takes them shots downstairs. Buckley being an experienced pro, you'll notice.
It's going to be a difficult fight for Tony Walker to score this, because all of those shots are landing off the target area, and they're landing on arms, they're landing on gloves, they're landing on shoulders. Clean scoring shots are few and far between.
I'd just like to see Mark Bates throw more shots, basically. There's a good right hand there.
The thing is, Buckley looks so good when he's coming forward.
Exactly. As Mark Bates is sitting back, Buckley's starting to take initiative and unload his shots. As we said before, the sixth round soon goes by, and you can't afford to drop too many rounds. It's got to be another close round.
The cleaner shots for me, at any rate, I don't know whether you agree, Jimmy, cleaner shots were landed by this boy here, Peter Buckley.
No question, Buckley got through with the better shots in that round. Mark was threatening a lot, but not actually producing.
Well, I'm glad this contest being fought over 6 3-minute rounds, as opposed to 6 2-minute rounds. Jimmy and I have talked long and frequently on Pro Box about our dislike of 2-minute rounds, which we don't think does anybody any favours. And it's good to see that a young fighter like Mark Bates going 6 threes, learning how to pace himself during a bout, and he can only benefit.
Coming up for the fifth round now, Dave. This fight could, you know, very well be dead even or very, very close, and one of them got hold of it now by the scruff of the neck.
Round five.
And take over.
Well, I've got to say, I've got Peter Buckley in the white trunks marginally ahead.
Mark's letting Buckley become confident. He's catching Bates with good shots and growing in confidence. Mark's got to come back aggressively.
Yes, I think Freddie King's been...
And take it away.
I think Freddie King's been drumming this into Mark Bates in the inter-round. But I think Buckley has the confidence of knowing that the Bates really doesn't have the armoury to hurt him.
Mark coming at 9-2 as well, you know, he's very close to the featherweight division. I'm not saying Buckley is an exceptionally big junior lightweight, but he certainly looks quite strong. Just a touch of blood, I think, sucking out the right nostril.
Yeah, just a little smear of blood under Mark Bates' nose.
So there's obviously the accuracy there from Buckley. Mark needs to grab the initiative in this round and stop banging on that right hand now.
And Buckley even getting confident enough to try and out jab the longer reaching Bates.
I'm sure Buckley will be looking for success to the body. That's where it comes to this company. That's better from Bates. Tried the right hand over the top as a counter punch. And that'll make Buckley think more about just walking in. Gaining a little bit of respect out of this man. That was a good shot, and I think Bates was up. Shook the right hand there as
well.
Yeah, he's
forced to hold.
Got to tighten his axe up, keep his hands up nice and high. Dangerous right hands. They're coming over the top now.
Got him down, right hand.
That was a good, clean right hand. He needs to just grab hold, keep his hands up and get himself out of trouble. Mark Bates' head's hanging up in the air.
Yeah. I think this is going to be all over now.
Mark Bates needs to just keep his hands up and grab hold of Buckley. Get his head clear. That's the tactic, sir. Just hold on now. Good boy. Now Buckley's experienced pro, so he's looking to finish it here and now. Mark's just got to get through this round. Really shook up.
Well, that was a good round for Buckley.
It was a big round for Buckley, and going back to the corner, Mark Bates is absolutely sold out. He's shaking his head at Freddie King there. He's got 3 minutes to face just yet, and I don't think he'll be looking forward to it, but he's really got a grit his teeth now if he wants to pull this contest out of the fire. You know, Buckley's going to be on a roll now. He's going to be looking to end this. He isn't going to be thinking about a point to win now, Dave. He's going to look to come out and be exploding. You can see the shots here, and Buckley's planting himself, looking to land the big shot. There's the right hand he was talking about, which dropped Bates to the floor. Freddie's called the ref over. I don't know if as we see the action here, there's the right hand, and Bates really, that was a bang on. No defence against that right hand, and down he went.
And Tony Walker, I think, is calling a halt because Mark Bates has been retired by his corner.
I think that was a good decision by Freddie King in the corner there, because Mark, as he went back to the corner, he looked a little bit despondent with himself. And I think the next round would be in a very tough one, things have got for him. But he was on a roll and would have been looking to land the bomb.
Ladies and gentlemen, at the end of the fifth round, Mark Bates has retired with an injured hand. Ladies and gentlemen, Peter Buckley is the winner.
Injured hand, maybe the one that caused his six-month layoff.
And
injured pride as well, I fancy, as well as an injured chin. Mark Bates defeated by Peter Buckley, who wins
and
in five rounds. We're going to take a short... And Ian Strudwick. First of all, let's turn the spotlight onto the local man, Ian Strudwick. Ian Strudwick from Hockley, 27 years of age. We're going to take a look at Ian in action against Errol Crispy in this self-same Basildon ring back in June of last year. Now the fight went the full eight-round trip. Strudwick in the red, giving the former middleweight prospect all the trouble he could handle in this contest. Mike Jacobs, the referee, and at the end of the bout, it was Strudwick getting the verdict on points. As for Slugger O'Toole, well, if you're a boxing fan, you'll know that the Slugger's real name, which you believe is Fidel Castro Smith. Brendan Ingle, just in the corner of the shot there, christened him Slugger O'Toole. Well, what would you expect from Brendan? This is Slugger.